The two police officers have pleaded guilty to misconduct in public office. This is a horrific betrayal of trust. Two officers who were charged with guarding the murder scene, the scene where two sisters, Biba Henry and Nicole Smallman, were stabbed to death by Daniel Hussein on the 7th of June last year. Those officers should have been guarding the perimeter of that crime scene. Instead, they entered the crime scene, we're told, alerted members of the public and other colleagues that they were there via the WhatsApp messaging system, and then took photographs of the crime scene, including photographs of the bodies of these two sisters. In one photograph, we heard in court, the officers, one or both of the officers, we weren't quite sure on that point, superimposed their own head on top of images of the bodies of these sisters. An utterly shocking case on top of what was an appalling crime anyway. You'll remember last week that Daniel Hussein, this 19-year-old, was sentenced to 35 years in jail for murdering sisters Biba Henry and Nicole Smallman. They had been out celebrating Biba's 47th birthday, also celebrating the partial lifting of lockdown in Fryant Country Park in northwest London. It was late at night. They'd been there with friends. Friends drifted off. The two sisters were still there when Daniel Hussein, who was out looking for victims because of a bizarre pact he had made with the devil to murder six victims, innocent women, every 6 months in order, he thought, to have better luck with women and better luck winning the lottery. He had killed those two sisters. Police were convinced he would have gone on to murder other people had he not been stopped. So a terrible enough case, of course, for the family of these two sisters to come to terms with. And we heard from Mina Smallman, former archdeacon in the Church of England, the mother of the two sisters, who spoke of the real anguish and heartache that she had and her wish that Daniel Hussein spends the rest of his life behind bars. Now, she didn't speak really at any length about what these two officers have now pleaded guilty to, but there is no doubt she will have something to say, and we don't know whether that will be today or whether she will wait for the sentencing of these two officers, which we're told will take place, we believe, sometime in December.